Welcome everyone, I'm Ricky from Tech Talk and today is a very special video on the Huawei Mate 20X 5G. So today I'm going to go through the accessibility features and settings that we're going to find on this impressive phone from Huawei. So I believe this is a contender for my accessible device of 2019. That's thanks to a couple of different reasons that we're going to go through today. So first of all, one is the screen size. It's 7.2 inches in size, so it's quite big and it is quite a chunky phone to carry around. For someone that is visually impaired, I'm not worried about that. I've got a massive screen here that I can really enjoy all of my applications. Also, there is another added feature that we're going to talk about a little bit later on. So first of all, I want to show you the volume key shortcut option that will bring up Talkback. So when you first start your device, there are different accessibility options when you first begin, but you could also hold the volume keys together here.
Talkback on. Huawei Home.
So now Talkback is on and it said welcome to Huawei Home, or it's on Huawei Home. So you can use two fingers to move around.
Screen 2 of 2. Screen 1 of 2. Discover. Google search. Enter Hipboard. Huawei Home. Weather. Double tap and hold to long press.
So now I can actually go through my applications.
Phone. Contact. Messages. 3 notifications. Chrome. Camera. Double tap to activate. Double tap and hold to long press.
So it gives you the actions you need to do to actually use more features on your device. You can then select the time here.
Tuesday the 8th of October 1354.
I can also then select different things in my status bar along the top here.
4G phone signal full, battery 96%, 1354, NFC enabled.
So it goes through everything there for me that's enabled and what's usable on my device. Obviously know the time and the date, and also I know my battery percentage as well. Really helpful feature to have here. Also, this can be turned on in the settings. To turn this off, just use the volume keys.
Talkback off.
And then Talkback is off. When you first do this, the initial time, you'll go through a tutorial and it'll give you different lessons to go through, how to manipulate, how to sort of work with your device a little bit quicker as well, so you don't have to do them single taps. You can actually be quite quick. So really impressive to see that Talkback is on here. It's available right at the beginning when you first get your device, and I go through it in the accessibility of setting up a device. Also, it's available once your device is actually set up. Great feature to see there. Really impressed that Huawei is still including that in their options. Then to find all of your settings, go into the settings icon, which is a gear icon. Scroll all the way down to the bottom, 4 from bottom, 1, 2, 3, and 4. It's called Smart Assistance. So tap on this. So once tapped on this, you're going to get a range of different options here to go through. So starting off at the top, you've actually got accessibility. This is where the bulk of your settings are going to be. So tap accessibility. So inside the accessibility here, they're split into different sections. Our first section is audio. So at the top, you've got Talkback. You can tap on more settings here. There are loads of different settings that you can go through and change depending on your options that you want that's best for you and how you're going to use your smartphone here. So loads of different options in here to actually make it what you need it to be. Really impressive. You can also see turn Talkback on or off here as well. And then you can go through and use your device using Talkback. Again, because we showed you at the beginning, I'm just going to leave that part for the moment. Underneath that is a different variant to Talkback, which is called Select Speak. So if I turn this on here, you'll notice a new icon down here at the bottom, which is your little accessibility person. Tap this person, then tap play.
Navigate up. Select to speak. Select to speak. More settings. About. When Select to Speak is on, you can tap specific items on your screen to hear them aloud.
I can pause that here. I can then move on. And also, I could actually, if I stop here, press this again and actually press this section now.
When Select to Speak is on, you can tap specific items on your screen to hear them aloud.
So as you notice at the beginning, it read through everything right from the top. But then when I selected a certain area, it read from that area. This can work throughout the device, no matter applications you're in. If you're viewing websites, it's a really good feature to have, and I'm really pleased they've installed this option on here. You then have text to speech, which will go through your speech rate and your pitch. You can change and adjust these depending on how fast you want it to read, what pitch it needs to be, and then you can have an example. So if I turn this up really here, so listen to this example, which is really quick. So let's go back here.
This is an example of speech synthesis in English.
So then you can change and modify it depending on your choice, and you can reset back to default here. Nice customization options. Underneath that, you then have mono audio. So if you can only hear through mono audio, you can do. Then underneath that, you have captions. So once this is toggled on inside here, you can change your language, a range of different languages. You can change your text size, a range of different text sizes here. And also, you can actually have your caption style. 6 different options to choose from and whichever is preferable to you. Really nice to see that options are here. So that's everything that we found in the audio section. Then moving into the visual section, you've got color correction. So once we go in here, toggle this on, you then get this option. And you've got 3 different options to choose from here, depending on how people see and if they are affected by colors. Underneath that, you then have magnification. So one of my favorite features, toggle this on with a large display like this. 1, 2, 3. 3 quick taps, it zooms all the way in. Use 2 fingers to manipulate your way around. And we can sort of go everywhere we want to. I can then pinch in or zoom out using that pinch motion. 1, 2, 3 to come back. There's also another feature that I do like. 1, 2, 3, hold on your 3rd. And obviously it saved where I last zoomed out to. And then obviously I can manipulate my way around. As soon as I release, it jumps back to the default option. Really handy and a good option to have here. And I've used that option quite a lot and that'll work wherever you are on your device. You then have a large mouse pointer. So if you need to use a mouse pointer or an interaction control with your device, you can actually have a large mouse pointer, which can be helpful. Then you have color inversion. So currently we have the darkened menu option here. So it gives me a dark screen on my menu. That means my text is in white and the background is black. If I actually toggle this on here, you'll notice that it's now black text on a white background. Coming back home here, you can also see my whole home screen has been inverted. So just bear that in mind, depending which options. And I'll also show you where the darkened menu option is as well. So if I just toggle this off here, it'll go back to my chosen option. You then have high contrast text. So once you toggle this on, the darkened menu option as well will disappear and you'll have black text on white background. Underneath that, you have advanced visual effects. So if you don't want to have the advanced visual effects, you can just toggle that off here. Then moving into the interaction section, you have switch access. So switch access has become one of my most favorite options here. So if I toggle this on here, you can actually choose different switches and different interaction devices to use with your smartphone. So if you can't use your fingers or you can't use your hands to actually manipulate your way around your device, you can choose this option here and actually then use switches and interaction controls with your smartphone and actually use it as everyone else does, no matter your ability. Really good amount of options here. And also in the settings, you have a wide array of different customization options, again, that you can go through and change. So this is a general overview, but if you need any section talked about even more, please leave a comment down below and I'm sure I can help as much as I can. So really nice to see that option on here. Then underneath that, you have accessibility shortcuts. So accessibility shortcut, as you know, was the volume key shortcut option. Also, if you want to, you can actually change that option. So you can have select to speak, can have color correction, you can then have switch access. It just depends which option you want. Actually have the accessibility menu as well. It's just so nice that there's so much customization here from Huawei and of course Google. Underneath that, you've got touch and hold delay. So you've got short, medium and long. Also, you have click when cursor stops. So if you use a mouse pointer, as we've sort of changed, you can see its size, this will actually click for you and make an action come true once you've stopped moving around your display. Then finally down here at the bottom, you've got power button ends calls. One thing I want to highlight about the power button, and I will be showing you, is that it has a different color and a different texture as well. So you can really identify where your power button is down here on the right hand side. Then finally at the bottom, this bottom section here is downloaded services. So if you've downloaded a third party service, that's actually where it's gonna be. So that's everything that we're gonna find in the accessibility options. Coming back here, there are different options here that you can change and use depending on what you want to do. So one of them is called High Touch. So High Touch is a shopping application basically that uses Amazon. So if I show you what it does here, so say you had a image on your device like a case or something you're looking on a website, you can press and hold 2 thumbs together on the actual display and that case will try and find itself on Amazon and use the high AI systems inside then to actually give you the best option, and you can go through and purchase if you so wish to. Then also it's available in the camera as well. You can use it in the camera. Underneath that, you've got one hand mode. So if you want to just use one hand, as it is a large display, it's already toggled on, but one quick swipe here in the corner, we'll take it to this bottom corner and you can see easily then I can manipulate whatever I sort of want to do on my smartphone. Really simple and easy to do, but also just a quick tap here as well. Then you also have the diagonal motion as well, or you can come to this side, just depends what hand you actually are using when you use your smartphones. It might be your left or it might be your right. Then you have motion control. So some of my favorite options are inside here. So the first option is flip. So you can mute incoming calls and mute timers and alarms. So you can either turn these on or off by just flipping your phone around and actually putting its screen down to a desk or a surface. Underneath that, you have pickup. So once you pick your device up, I have straight away here that it will wake device. It will reduce timer and alarm sounds, which is helpful, and also reduce call ringtone volume. So if you're getting a call, you pick it up, it's going to reduce it straight away before you even start answering your call. Really helpful option. Then you have raise the ear. So raise the ear is a little bit different here. Once you do this, you can actually answer a call. You can make calls. You have smart speaker and then smart Bluetooth headset. So you can change and adjust the options that you want to choose here. Underneath that, you have take a screenshot. So if I tap this here with a knuckle, just double tap and it'll take a screenshot for me. Very simple and easy to do. Then you can change and adjust that and send it off, or if it's not, it'll just dismiss and it'll save it into your photos for later on. You then have open applications, so you can open apps. So if I toggle this on here, you can draw different letters to open different applications. Draw a C for the camera. So if I draw a C, there we go, the camera app opens. Really helpful and a really good idea here. Just again, different ways to use your device no matter your ability. So one of my favorite options here is split screen. To use split screen, all I'm gonna do is draw a line with my knuckle. And there we go. So as you can see now, I can open a different application. So like YouTube here, and then I can have YouTube videos while I'm still looking at the menu options here. Also, you can turn this around as well. With a 7.2 inch display, it's actually easier to use two applications, and it's actually very manipulative of both. So you can use both at the same time. Really different option, and I'm really pleased to see that. Also, you can change and adjust the window size as well, depending on your choice. Really like split screen, and it's a really good thing to have here with such a large device. Underneath that, you have your smart cover. So if you have the Huawei smart cover, you can use them options inside here. Same as the M Pen as well. You can use a pen here to draw different things and to manipulate your device depending what you're doing. So that split screen option, and again, it's just really handy to have if you have the M Pen. I will put the link in description for you so you can go and purchase the M Pen for this device. Underneath that, you then have mistouch prevention. So if I touch up here and touch down here, it sort of knows which one I'm actually meaning to touch. A really good option to have. You then have glove mode as well. If you have gloves on, you can actually use the smartphone with gloves. I think that's a really helpful thing. Then finally at the bottom here, you have scheduled power on and off. So if you want to power your device on or off at a certain time, you can actually set that up here quite easily. And finally down here at the bottom, it says looking for other settings. And one of the options it's actually suggesting is system navigation. So system navigation is really good, and you can have different options. So you can have a navigation dock, you can have the traditional 3-button capacitive touch buttons that we have here, or you can use gestures. I prefer using gestures, but if you are needing to use the accessibility options where you need the accessibility man down here, you're gonna need the 3 capacitive touch buttons. So please bear that in mind. So I'm gonna keep that as it's set there. So that's all the options you're gonna find in Smart Assistant. So quite a lot of different sections there to go through. If you do have any issues, please drop a comment down below and I will be more than happy to help. So a couple of other options that I just wanna show you. So battery, first of all, inside battery, I don't know why it's here. So one of the options in battery is darken interface colors. So if I toggle this off here, this is where it's gonna go back to the traditional way of a black text on a white background, but I prefer it the other way around. And obviously it is going to save your battery as well, because it's an OLED panel, which means the blacks are truly black because there's nothing actually turned on behind it. The other set of options I want to go through is in display. So first of all, you have your brightness. Your device is very bright here, and it's very manipulated depending on what you want to actually set it to. When it's outside as well, it works really good. Also, you have automatic, so it will set automatic depending where you are. You then have color mode and temperature. So inside here, you've got vivid or normal. Don't like the word normal, but you've got vivid or normal. And also you can change your color temperature depending on the choice that you want to have. And it'll sort of have a standard sort of hue to the display. Again, nice that they offer different options inside here that you can manipulate and change it to the way you want it to be. Another option inside here is eye comfort. So eye comfort is really important. So if I toggle this on here, you'll see the screen takes away a bit of that harsh blue light, and you're going to notice it a lot more at nighttime compared to what you're going to notice it here because of the bright lights that I have. But if I turn this all the way up, you can see that white text is now more yellow compared to here where it's more sharper white. So again, you can schedule this on and off and you can choose which way you want to have it. But it's nice that it has it in there and worried about your eyesight. Another option I like inside here, which I wish was in accessibility, is text and display size. As you can see, my display text is already quite high, just making it easier for me to read when I'm actually making these videos. Also, you have a couple of presets up here at the top and you can change and adjust these depending on your choice. You then have screen resolution. So screen resolution is really important because when you first get your device, it will come under sort of smart resolution. So it will try and find the best one for you. If you turn this off, you can then choose the best option to get the best out of your display depending on your choice. So it really up to you, whatever's best for you. So I'm going to say yes for this one because I want it to sort of keep my battery sort of good and stable. You then have more display settings. So inside here, you've got full screen display. So it will give you full screen display on some of these applications. And once you add in more applications, it will add in more as well. But you've got the choice there. Then also you've got the notch option to have the notch on your device. So it's quite a small notch here. It's not as big as what they're saying is here, but I can actually hide that if I want to. And it just depends up to you, your choice. I just keep it as this one. As it doesn't bother me, it's like teardrop notch design anyway. And finally at the bottom, two other options that I want to just talk about is an always on display, first of all. So if we show you this, you can have an always on display that's always on. So once you lock your device here, give it a couple of seconds, you've got the time, the date, and also notifications will come there as well. Also, one of the other options is simple mode. So simple mode is pretty self-explanatory. It makes it really simple. The app's a lot bigger and a lot more easier to manipulate and use your device depending on your options. So I'm really pleased to see that option is on side here as well. Simple mode, and then I can actually exit out simple mode. It'll take me back to my default home screen here. So that is everything that we're gonna find in the menus, and there might be more. I'm digging around always, but I will update you. Really impressed with the amount of settings that Huawei are giving on devices now, and it's really taken a move. Considering I've been looking at Huawei devices now for the last 3 years, it's really stepped up. They're adding more settings, adding different options. As well as the devices, they also come up with great services and other applications. So you might have heard a story sign, and I'm gonna be bringing you a video about that. That's where it uses a smartphone to help a family read a book together, where it will sign the book for you. Also, another service that is available through the Huawei app gallery is PocketVision. So I've done a detailed sort of TV advert about PocketVision and actually launched PocketVision with Honor. So as Honor are a part of Huawei, the Huawei app gallery also has PocketVision on it. And what I'll do in the description is link it down to PocketVision so you can go and experience PocketVision. So really impressed with the amount of settings and the different options that we're going to find on the Huawei Mate 20X 5G. If you have any questions or any queries regarding any of the settings or any of the options, I will try my best to reply to every comment, and I really do mean that, because without you my channel wouldn't be possible. While you're leaving a comment, please do leave a like, and also if you haven't yet already, subscribe to the channel to stay updated with all of my latest videos. From me, Ricky, and the Huawei Mate 20X 5G, I will see you in my next video. Bye for now.